there's two different fashion shows going on today. The first one is the Fun with Fashion show, and I'd like to describe that one to you a little bit in case you're not familiar with it. The Fun with Fashion outfits have been purchased or sewn to meet a prescribed scenario and budget. Points are awarded for showmanship, grooming, coordination of outfit, accessories, fit, and conforming to the budget. Awards will be given immediately following the show. For the Clover Collection show, 4-H fashions feature sewn garments by the 4-H members. Outfits are judged on construction and fit prior to the show. Points are awarded for modeling skills, posture, poise, grooming, fit, and accessories. Before each class, it'll be announced which show that the class is in. So I hope that all of you enjoy the show and stick around for the awards afterwards. Thanks and welcome to the fair.
I want to add my welcome to Kelly's. I'm Alice Darnell, one of the 4-H agents here, and I hope you'll enjoy our show. I wanted to introduce our teen MCs. We do usually let our teenagers that are involved do that for us. And you've met Kelly. Come on up, Kelly. Kelly's a senior this year at Franklin High School, and she, a couple of weeks ago, went to our 4-H Roundup and won the state clothing and textiles competition, and she gets to go to the National Congress. Thank you. We also have Victoria Schwer. Victoria is also a senior at Franklin High School, also attended Roundup, and she won the state competition in photography and will also get to go to Atlanta to the National 4-H Congress this fall. Thank you. Christian Schwer. Christian is a sophomore at Franklin High School. Christian's main projects are clothing and food science. She also went to Roundup and was a finalist in food science. Thank you. All right. Now, these teens are going to be reading the descriptions as our 4-H members model on stage, so enjoy the show.
First up today, we have Clover Collection, Schoolwear, Class 10, Grades 9 through 12. First, we have Kelly Burgess. Kelly is a senior at Franklin High School. She enjoys clothing and textiles and was a state winner in her project this past year. She was also a leadership finalist. Kelly enjoys ballet and tap and is part of Habitat for Humanity. The little black dress is back. Kelly made this dress knowing that it could be worn for almost any occasion. The dress is fully lined with a cotton polyester broadcloth, which helps the dress lay smoothly. The length and double strap design makes it perfect for a fall day early in the school year. To make the dress into a school outfit, she has chosen to use colorful accents to dress it down. She put a simple red belt around her waist and also a chunky colored bubble necklace to add a playful look. Kelly can't wait to see where this classy attire will take her in the coming school year. Thank you, Kelly. Next, we have Clover Collection, Schoolwear, Class 7, Grades 6 through 8. First, we have Kelsey Dillon. Kelsey is in the 8th grade at Page Middle School. She enjoys Fun with Fashion and Clover Collection. She likes art, reading, volleyball, and helping her dad with projects. Kelsey is dressed for the first day of school in her white cotton blouse with a blue floral and butterfly pattern, which she has matched with a pair of navy blue floral patterned lightweight denim leggings. She has accented the outfit with a blue beaded necklace and a matching bracelet. Thank you, Kelsey.
Just kiss me slowly.
Next, we have Clover Collection, grades 4 through 5. First, we have Camille Woods. Camille is a sixth grader at Sunset. She enjoys golf, volleyball, singing, acting, sewing, and science. Camille is showing off her wonderful casual dress. She is ready for fall, looking cute and stylish. The different colored polka dots are keeping it fun and full of personality. This dress is perfect for making every day cute and fashionable. She learned from this outfit that you have to be patient when sewing. Thank you, Camille. Next, we have Clover Collection, Class 1, grades 4 through 5. First, we have Bella Liberty Fisk. Bella is homeschooled and is in the 5th grade. She enjoys reading, playing guitar, writing songs, riding her bike, and playing basketball. Bella is wearing a made-it-herself skirt, and the accessories she's wearing are her favorite cowgirl hat and her cowboy boots. The theme of her skirt is rodeo fun. Bella's look is inspired by one of her favorite books, Rodeo Summer. Bella is also wearing her favorite Western wear shirt made of 100% cotton and is light and comfortable enough to wear for a ride on her horse. A girl can still look very fashionable while getting dirty in the rain. Bella's straw cowgirl hat was given to her by her aunt, who manages a co-op. Bella is very proud of it. Her boots are perfect for stepping out either on a horse or in the rodeo ring, or walking in the fair midway aisles. Bella is ready for some fair or rodeo fun in her comfortable yet fashionable Western wear. Thank you, Bella. Our next MC is Christian. In a way, it's the same as the one before this, and I wish I could say. Up next, we have Fun with Fashion School Wear, grades 4 through 5. Your class is invited to attend a banquet concert at a nearby high school. You want to look nice because you may be asked to join the band on stage for a special presentation. Select a casual outfit that looks good on you, fits well, and is appropriate for school. Pictures will be taken. You have $45 that you can spend. Up first, we have Capri Easter Day. Capri will be in 5th grade at Sunset Elementary School this year. She enjoys art, music, drama, fashion, basketball, and church. Capri is wearing a stylish outfit, which she will enjoy at school this fall. Her top is a cute, ruffled, smocked shirt with a long ruffle at the bottom. There is a colorful stitching at the waist for a fashionable finish. Capri is also wearing dark skinny jeans with heart back pockets to add style. Her hair is in a side fishtail braid with an adorable gemstone headband. Her shoes are black flats with bows. Capri will surely enjoy this outfit this fall. Thank you, Capri. Up next, we have Riley McPherson. Riley won first place in Fun with Fashion and Clover Collection in 2012. Riley's hobbies include volleyball and art. Riley is sure to have fun on this special day with a tiered dress in royal blue. She pairs that with bright peach jeans, a light chambray denim jacket, and gladiator sandals. To complement her style, she chose a cream rose ring and orange bangle. To tie her look all together, she selected a festive beaded necklace. Thank you, Riley.
it's all gonna be alright.
Can I please have all the contestants back on stage? And turn. And turn back around. Thank you, girls.
Just like I wasn't scared at all. I turned off the car.
Up next, we have Schoolwear, Class 5, Grades 6 through 8. Today, you will be presenting your 4-H Project Fair exhibit to your class. You want to make a good impression on your classmates and judges, so select an outfit that makes you feel confident and look trendy. Clothes should look good on your body type and be appropriate for school. You have $50. Up first, we have Kelsey Dillon. Kelsey will be in 8th grade at Page Middle School this year. Her main projects include Fun with Fashion, Clover Collection. She enjoys reading, volleyball, and working with her dad on special projects. Kelsey is styling a pair of lightweight black skinny dress pants with a cream-colored floral lace top that ruffles at the bottom. She has paired it with a black and cream colored bracelet and a chained necklace with a brass bow. She added a pair of fabric flats in the color black with a touch of gray. She found the perfect small clutch to match her outfit in her mom's closet to carry everything she will need for a day at school. With the great savings she discovered at Forever 21, she will certainly get an A for fashion in today's speech presentation. Thank you, Kelsey. Up next, we have Schoolwear, Class 7, Grades 9 through 12. Your school is hosting a student organization event that will be attended by students from several area high schools. You will serve as one of the moderators for the event and will be on stage. Select an outfit that is appropriate for school and looks great on you. Consider current trends, but select based on styles that flatter your body type. You may spend $55 or less. Up first, we have Kelly Burgess. Kelly's main projects are clothing and textiles, and she was a state level 2 winner. Kelly is so excited to show off her new high fashion school outfit. The tribal print high-low skirt is the focus of her outfit. She found it first and then designed the rest of the ensemble around it. The browns and oranges fit into the bohemian style while the blue accents tone down the temperature. With this focal piece, Kelly paired a royal blue blouse to bring out the accents in the skirt. The cool, loosely fit style is perfect for the hot summer months, especially with the open lace back. She has accessorized her outfit with large silver hoop earrings with turquoise accents. Kelly chose to put a pair of aqua blue and tan colored sandals under her feet to bring in another shade of color. Kelly is ready for success in this trendy, upbeat ensemble. Thank you, Kelly. Up next, we have Victoria Schweer. Victoria is now a senior at Franklin High School. Her main project is photography, and she has a special appreciation for fashion photography. Victoria is prepared and polished to act as a moderator for her school's events. Today, she is wearing designer brands that she was able to purchase within her budget by shopping smart during sales and at consignment boutiques. Her salmon button-down blouse by Ann Taylor provides the perfect pop of color to her outfit. Victoria purchased it at Goodwill during their monthly half-price sale. Her royal blue trousers from the Donna Karan New York collection add a touch of sophistication needed for her role on stage. She purchased them from TJ Maxx. Victoria tops off her ensemble with a classic white button-down cardigan from New York & Company, which she purchased during a back-to-school sale. She completes her outfit with matching royal blue earrings and a large gold bangle bracelet. Victoria is dressed to impress in her chic yet collegiate attire. Thank you, Victoria. Can I please have all the contestants back on stage? And turn. And turn back. Thank you, ladies. We're going to switch the mic back over to Victoria.
Next up, we have Fun with Fashion Best Wear, grades 9 through 12, class 8. You have been selected as a finalist for a scholarship by a professional organization. This scholarship committee has asked to interview you and other finalists. Knowing that appearance is important in making a good impression, guys should wear dress pants and include a tie as part of their ensemble. Ladies should wear a dressy pantsuit, skirted suit, or a dress. This is a chance to show off your personality with a dressy outfit of your choice. Look for colors, fabrics, and styles that look great on you. Make sure your outfit is age appropriate and don't spend more than $70 on the clothes and accessories. First, we have Christian Schwier. Christian is a sophomore at Franklin High School. Her main 4-H projects are fashion, food science, and photography. And she recently attended 4-H Roundup as a state finalist in food science. She is also on the Junior Fair Board. Christian has chosen a traditional pantsuit for her scholarship interview. Her classic pinstripe blazer by Jones New York Country is tailored to fit her petite stature. She bought it at Goodwill for only $4. Christian matched it with a pair of basic black trousers, a necessity in every wardrobe. They are by Copper Key from Dillard's and were purchased from the clearance rack during additional discount days. To keep her business look professional, she minimally accessorized with a pair of simple pearl earrings. Christian will surely impress the judges with her refined genteel attire. Thank you, Christian. Next, we have Best Wear, Class 6, grades 6 through 8. You are receiving an award for outstanding community service at a Chamber of Commerce luncheon. Dressy clothes are required. Boys should select dress pants, shirt, and tie. Girls should wear a dressy pants outfit, skirt, and blouse, or a dress. Jackets are optional. You may spend up to $65 on clothes for this event. First, we have Taylor Vale. Taylor is in the 8th grade at Page Middle School. Her main 4-H projects include line and design, an honor club, and she likes music, sewing, and concerts. Taylor is ready for the awards luncheon, dressed in this zigzag design, multicolored dress. Special details include red braided leather belt and two cutouts in the back. The light cover-up is cotton knit in white. She has a multicolored necklace with jewels that match the color of the dress. Her clutch is a blue and black artificial snakeskin. Flats complete the look. Thank you, Taylor.
It's always been about me, myself, and I. I thought relationships were nothing but a waste.
Next, we have Best Wear, grades 4 through 5. You have a close relative graduating from college. Many family pictures will be taken, and your mother wants you to look nice. You must wear a dressy outfit. You may choose dress pants and a shirt, a skirt and a blouse, a dress, or a suit. Choose something that is age appropriate, fits well, and is flattering. You can spend no more than $65 on clothes and accessories. First, we have Grace Schultz. She is in the 6th grade at Bethesda. She enjoys dance, cheerleading, and likes music, animals, and people. Today, Grace is wearing a lovely, colorful halter dress with ties around the neck. She bought it for a great bargain at Here We Grow Again consignment store. Grace has added a lightweight navy blue sweater and sparkly shoes and other cute accessories to top it off. All of this cost her only $25. Grace is ready for the fashion show on this fun summer day. Thank you, Grace. Next, we have Summer Foster, who is in the 5th grade at Crockett. Grace enjoys sketching and design, performing all kinds of dance, and spending time with her family. She also enjoys helping out with the Special Olympics. Summer's mom asked her to look nice for a family member's graduation, and Summer really delivered with the flattering ensemble. This sleeveless, A-line layered dress with a peekaboo satin bow in the back shows real style. The bold scarlet color and square neckline keep this dress stylish and fun. Notice how her butterfly hair clip matches the vibrant color of the dress. The butterfly is again reflected in her silver strap shoes. Her faux diamond earrings complement the sparkling buckles on her snow white purse. Take lots of pics, Summer. Thank you. Next, we have Raman Nieman. She is in the 5th grade at Scales Elementary School. She enjoys chorus, Girl Scouts, riding horses, and vaulting. Raman is wearing a Roxette pink and black high-low dress. She is wearing black ballet flats with bows on the tops from American Eagle. She has accessorized her ensemble with a gold love necklace from Aldo and pink and from Aldo, a pink and black clutch, and gold earrings. Robin is surely at her best this summer in her lovely ensemble. Thank you, Robin. Next, we have Kate Welton. She attends Sunset Elementary School. She enjoys cooking and skateboarding. Kate is ready for her cousin's graduation. She has chosen a white lace tiered dress with black bracelets and black sandals. Her necklace and earrings coordinate as well. Kate has also chosen a black hair clip. She is dressed appropriately for any dressy occasion. Thank you, Kate. Will all of our contestants come back on stage? In turn. And turn back around. Thank you.
Up next, we have Clover Collection grades 9 through 12 for best wear. First up, we have Kelly Burgess. Kelly is proud to have the opportunity to wear this specially designed suit ensemble. She coordinated the caramel-colored jacket with leopard pocket accents with the black and leopard skirt in order to have an outfit that looks great together without having too much of the same color. Kelly chose the caramel material for the jacket because it was the perfect weight that can be worn all year long with its three-quarter length sleeves. She even mixed two variations of the jacket pattern together to get just the combination she wanted. The most difficult, yet most educational part of this outfit for Kelly was making the collar on the jacket. So the skirt is simple yet stylish with the trendy color block piercing. Pairing these two pieces together, Kelly has made a youthful yet professional look. Thank you, Kelly. Up next, we have Clover Collection Best Wear, grades 6 through 8. First up, we have Kelsey Dillon. She is now in 8th grade at Page Middle School. Kelsey is ready to make a lasting impression on anyone she meets while attending an awards banquet for her school in her summery linen dress of soft white with plum color design. The dress is certain to attract attention with its accents in black and white and a touch of sparkle. She has paired this with a comfortable pair of sandals and a simple necklace. She has also pulled her hair back with an accessory she made from the remnants of the fabric from the dress. Thank you, Kelsey. Up next, we have Clover Collection Sportswear, grades 4 through 5. First up, we have Camille Woods. Camille is now in 6th grade at Edmondson Elementary School. This stylish romper is great for any day when you are on the go. From playing outside to shopping, this romper is an easy and cute outfit choice. The polka dots bring out the personality and the bright color adds interest for this look. Look at me ensemble. Camille is stepping out in fun fashion. Camille enjoys school choir, golf team, Cool for Christ, and working with inner city children. She also enjoys acting, sewing, and science. Thank you, Camille. Up next, we have Fun with Fashion, Sportswear, grades 6 through 8. You are participating in a community-wide festival. Your job will be walking around the festival, giving away balloons, and answering questions. Dress comfortably. Because this is a public event, you must avoid clothing that would be considered inappropriate. Skimpy tops and very short shorts should be avoided. mid-calf or longer shorts, capri pants, mid-calf or longer skirts or skorts, or athletic type pants are fine. Spend no more than $50. Up first, we have Karina Robbie. She is now in seventh grade at Page Middle School. She enjoys writing, reading, volleyball, acting, trombone, piano, and guitar. Walking around outside on a summer day can be uncomfortable if you're wearing the wrong clothes. But fortunately for Karina, she is going to be plenty comfortable and fashionable in her cute outfit. She is wearing navy Hollister capri length pants, perfect for doing lots of walking. For her top, she is wearing a turquoise high-low sheer back tank, coupled with blue and gray to add layers. To match her comfy tank, she is also wearing turquoise and gray Nike tennis shoes to add an athletic touch. Karina is also sure to bring along her stylish white aviator style sunglasses, so her eyes will be plenty protected from harmful UV rays. Lastly, she has chosen to wear a useful polka dot leather and tweed rust sack to hold water and other personal belongings. All in all, Karina is sure to catch people's eyes with her fun, comfy, and chic outfit. Thank you, Karina. Up next, we have Fun with Fashion Sportswear, grades 4-5. You are volunteering at an event for preschool children at a local park. Select an outfit that is comfortable enough for you to play with children and appropriate for a junior leader. Event organizers stipulate no extra short shorts or tops that show your midriff. You have $45. First up, we have Grace Cleaver. Grace is now in fifth grade at Oakview Elementary School. Grace enjoys dancing and jumping on the trampoline. She is also in chorus, basketball, and cheerleading. Grace has chosen some pink denim shorts with a frayed hem. To complement the shorts, she has chosen a gray tank top with a pink lace vest. The sparkly heart design on the shirt with the bright colors gives the outfit a punch of style. She has chosen matching flip-flops to complete her look. Thank you, Grace.
Have you enjoyed the show so far? Thank you. We have our team still changing, so I do want to tell you a little bit about what goes on from here. The girls that win at this level, we will be invited to a regional level, so we can send two from each category to our regional fashion show, both in Clover Collection and in Fun with Fashion. That happens September the 9th on a Monday at the Tennessee State Fair. So they will be invited. So if your daughter wins one of the categories today, which is a lot of them, please let me know. I'll be sending you more about it. But if you think that that's a possibility, let me know. We do write letters to the school to excuse them from school that day, or at least part of the day. For that competition. So we hope that they will go on to that, and that's a lot of fun as well. There are 31 counties in our central region of 4-H, and so there'll be kids there from a lot of those. They might not all be represented, but a lot of them will, so that we are glad about that. Also to tell you, the Clover Collection outfits were judged earlier today. They were sewn by the girls, and so they judged them off of them, checking out those zippers and seams and hems, as well as on them. So that's what happened for those girls before the show today. The scenario for our last class for tonight is for the grades 9 through 12 formal wear. You are attending the State Conference for a Youth Organization, of which you are a member. The final banquet of the conference is formal. Ladies are expected to wear a formal gown. Gentlemen are expected to wear a suit and tie. Select your ensemble for the banquet, keeping cost and style in mind. You want to look classy and elegant while maintaining a youthful flair. You have $125 that you may spend on your ensemble, so you will need to shop wisely. Our first contestant, Kelly Burgess. As you've heard before, Kelly's from Franklin High School, a senior. She has been in dance for a long time with ballet and point and tap. She volunteers for Habitat for Humanity. Tonight, Kelly is dressed in emerald green from head to toe in this playful party dress. This dress says it all, with many unique aspects, including a sweetheart neckline and a crisscross back. The bodice fits like a glove, but the skirt is full because of the layers of tulle underneath. Kelly's favorite part of this dress is that from a distance, the materials appear black and velvet-like, but up close, it shimmers with emerald sparkles. She has accessorized this outfit with simple but classy emerald jewelry, including a necklace, earrings, and a ring. She is wearing simple black heels on her feet that can be worn with almost any formal outfit. Complete with flashy bling, Kelly is ready for the banquet. Thank you, Kelly. Our second contestant, Christian Schwier, sophomore at Franklin High School. Christian has had many accomplishments, including first place in both the county and regional Fun with Fashion shows last year. She also attended Roundup in Food Science and has won many awards for her canning, photography, textiles, and baking here at the Williamson County Fair. She's also in the Interact Club, the Thespian Club, and is a cheerleader. Christian dazzles her midnight blue formal dress from Blondie Nights by Stacey Sklar. She has chosen this form-fitting one-shoulder dress for the conference banquet because of its comfort and sophistication. The side ruffle and the fabric's gold shimmer adds to the dress's elegance. Christian accessorizes her gown with a gold bracelet and earrings enhanced by rhinestones. She was able to keep her costs low by shopping Dillard's clearance racks during additional discount days. Christian looks ravishing in her beautiful yet budget-friendly ensemble. Thank you, Christian. Our third contestant tonight is Victoria Schreer. Victoria's main project is photography, and she has a special appreciation for fashion photography. She's a senior at Franklin High. She was honored in December with outstanding 10th grade 4-H award. She's won many awards for her photography at this fair, the Cock County Fair, and the Williamson County Photo Contest. She is also currently serving on the Junior Fair Board. She enjoys modeling, photography, acting. She is in the Thespian Club, the Movement, and the Interact Club. Tonight, Victoria looks stunning at the conference banquet in her navy blue formal dress by What a Beautiful Life. It features a pleat crossover neckline and fitted bodice with a flared long skirt. She accented her dress with rhinestone earrings, necklace, and bracelet. Victoria was mindful of the environment and was able to stay well under her budget by purchasing gently used items from Goodwill and a consignment boutique. Victoria is prepared to make a statement at this year's conference. Thank you, Victoria. All right, I'd like to ask all three girls to come back on stage. Baby, it's sure. please turn to the back. All right, thank you, girls. All right, we're ready for awards. I want all of the Clover Collection participants to come on up stage. If you were in the Clover Collection, please come on stage. So Kelly is going to announce some of the winners, and I'll announce some of the winners. We are so proud of everyone, and as I said before, first and second in every class will be invited to our regional show.
Okay, for class one, beginning sewing, our first place winner is Bella Fisk. In class three, active sportswear, our first place winner is Camille Woods. In class four, schoolwear, our first place winner is Camille Woods. In class seven, schoolwear, our first place winner is Kelsey Dillon. In class 8, best wear, our first place winner is Kelsey Dillon.
Okay. First place in school wear for 9 through 12, Kelly Burgess. First place in formal wear, best wear, formal wear, Kelly Burgess. And for our best of show for all the Clover Collection outfits, Kelly Burgess for her best wear. All right, thank you, girls. Okay, thank you very much. Now we'll do fun with fashion. If you just finished the fourth or fifth grade and we're in fun with fashion, come up on the stage. Checking my tongue in the mirror and bending over backwards just to try to see it clearer, but my breath fogged up the glass, and so I drew a new face and I laughed. I guess what I'll be saying is there ain't no better reason to rid yourself. Okay, this is just the fourth and fifth grade classes right here. Our first place winner in active sportswear is Grace Cleaver. Okay, if there's more than one person in the class, I'm going to ask that you step forward when you hear your name called so we know where to bring your ribbon to. Okay, for class two, school wear, our second place winner is Riley McPherson. Our first place winner is Capri Easterday. Okay, in class three, best wear, our fourth place winner is Kate Welton. Our third place winner is Robin Neiman. Our second place winner is Summer Foster. And our first place winner is Grace Showate. Thank you. Y'all can. Great job to everybody. Now we're going to ask the 6th through 8th grade Fun with Fashion participants to come to the stage.
heard there was a secret chord David played and it pleased the Lord, but you don't.
For Class 4 Active Sportswear, our first place winner is Karina Rovey.
It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the
mile. For Class 5 Schoolwear, our first place winner is Kelsey Dillon. For Class 6 Best Wear, our first place winner is Taylor Vail. Thank you, girls. Great job.
All right, and these are our senior high members. And this is for school wear. Our second place in school wear goes to Kelly Burgess. And first place to Victoria Schwer. All right. And in our best wear category, Christian Schwer wins first place. And I'll just bring the ribbons for the formal wear in just a minute. Third place for formal wear goes to Kelly Burgess. Second place to Victoria Schwer. And first to Christian Schwer.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And there's one more ribbon to be awarded. Our best of show for fun with fashion goes to Christian Schwer for her formal wear.
Baby, I've been here before.
All right, please give these three a hand for helping me out with the emceeing. Thank you very much. And give all the girls a wonderful hand for being having a wonderful show. And I want to thank my four judges today, Frank Comer, Laura Kate Gagne, Leslie Mitchell, and Allison Neal. Give them a hand, too. Thank you so much.
I think the catalyst is money. My best month, I made $50,000.
In 2005, Jim Vitale was convicted for his role in a business opportunity scam.
There was ridiculous money being made. You know, you could take down $20 million in 8 months.
He sold the American dream, the dream of being your own boss.
It's basically learning how to listen and manipulate people. Once you understand the dynamics of what you're trying to do, which is separate them from their money, that's it.
Business opportunity fraud occurs when someone tells you that they will give you what you need to successfully operate a profitable business. And when they do that in a way that guarantees and ensures your success.
Every year, thousands of people lose millions of their hard-earned dollars to con artists selling fraudulent business opportunities.
The telltale signs of business opportunity fraud are you can earn a lot of money. I will show you how to do it, and you can count on being successful.
It all starts with an ad full of promises.
Things like stay at home, no real legwork required, turnkey business opportunity, things that get people's attention. And then they call in.
Sometimes the voices behind these claims are celebrities.
Hi, folks. I'm Adam West. Oh, I wish I'd had one of these in the old cave. It's called Easy Link.
And every feature could earn money for you.
For a piece of tomorrow, call now.
When somebody responds to one of their advertisements, there's a very careful process to lure them in.
Hey, how are you, Jim? First thing I want you to do is grab a pen. I want you to write my name down. Now I have control. I'm already telling you what to do. I give you my name, my phone number. I tell you a little bit about myself. And then I set an appointment, and I also give you references.
Craig D'Angelo is from upstate New York. A TV ad said he could get in on the ground floor of a new high-tech revolution by owning and operating internet kiosks.
My main goal for getting into for buying the machines wasn't so that I could have a business and retire and get rich. I was just looking for something to supplement things and really kind of make it easier for my wife and kids. I was a police officer at the time, and I was very cynical, dealt with people who got scammed before. So, you know, I was really looking for the warning signs.
It sounded simple and lucrative. A plan that couldn't miss.
You got to remember, this is before Wi-Fi and before Twitter and all that, before these Blackberries could do everything. So it was really awesome to have a terminal that you could walk up and throw a buck or two in and check your email, get money out of, or pay a bill.
He called the Better Business Bureau. There were no complaints against the Easy Link company. Then he sat down with his wife and father to discuss the investment.
I bought two machines. I ended up paying like $12,500 a piece for them, so $25,000. Which was a lot of money. And I didn't have that money laying around. I took a second mortgage on my house to do this.
If somebody has figured out a foolproof way to earn a lot of money, why are they possibly going to tell you how to do that rather than just doing it for themselves all over the place? So be very skeptical.
The warning sign came right when it was kind of too late, and I think the jerk's name was Vitale. He said, thanks a lot, Craig, we're gonna make a lot of money together. And I said, oh man, I think I'm in for a ride.
The first thing that anybody interested in investing should do is ask for the written disclosure document. It should list all of the people who have purchased the business opportunity. If there are any earnings representations being made, there's a separate earnings claim document. If they won't give you that, just don't go near it.
Like Craig, Deborah Eaton thought she'd found a solid business opportunity.
I've got right here a cashier's check for $8,500 that I mailed to them.
The company, Ameripause, repeatedly called Deborah over 6 months.
He had given me like four people to call to give me references that have been in the business for the last 2 years.
Let's be honest, you don't know me from a hole in the wall. You called a 1-800 number on the TV. I don't want you to take my word for it. Let me put you in touch with some distributors, people just like you.
One of the girls was in Kansas City, so we called her up. And she said that she sent her son through college with just the money she made off the machines.
Deborah and her husband hoped to retire on the income they would receive from five prepaid phone card machines.
These three were installed in different stores and never made a penny.
What they usually do is give you just a few references, and those references invariably are in cahoots with the fraudsters.
You have three of those Easy Link Machines?
Yes, I do.
How's it going?
Going fine. I start out with one, and I bought another two about 3-4 months later.
Can I ask you how soon you recouped your money?
Sure. The first machine in about 10 months.
Wow, so you're doing pretty well.
Yeah.
Even if it's the kind of business that doesn't require a storefront, you need to go and visit them physically. You need to see what the setup is. Go to their homes. Ask to see a list of their accounts.
Oh, you'll get it back in 3 months. But I'm going to say 6 just to be on the safe side. 3 months? Wow. Are you sure? Oh, yeah, I've had people do it a lot sooner than that even. This is great. No, it wasn't great. It was a nightmare.
If you're talking to somebody who is asking questions in reference to the legitimacy of the business, at that point, you do a slap takeaway. You know what, Jim? Let's stop now because I have a whole full day of appointments with people who are looking to get into this business, who want to make money, not people who are going to pick apart my disclosures line by line. Okay, with all due respect, listen, there's plenty of things out there. Take your time, shop around. You want to give me a call back in a couple of months? If I have something available, I'll be willing to put you in it. But right now, I need to focus on somebody who's serious.
When they tell you, you need to hurry up and make your decision because there are other people who are also interested in buying this opportunity in your area and there are only a certain number of opportunities, back off. That is a sure sign of fraud.
And it may come as no surprise that when the economy is in decline, fraud is on the rise.
You have people who have been successful for the last 10 years, so they got a little something put away. Now, you know, they took their expense account, they cut their overtime, so now they're looking to increase their earning potential. Business opportunities can boom in a recession and in a downturn of the economy.
You know that show Get Smart, where he walks down the hallway and these doors open up, all right? And as he goes through a door shuts behind you? It's like that. It was like this process they had you through, going through, you know, you walk through a door, bang, the door shuts behind you, you're not going back. They knew exactly what they were doing, and they were very, very good at it. And by the time you get to that little phone booth at the end, and you dial that number to make the purchase, whew, down the chute you go, and your money's gone.
Nobody in business is going to give you your money back if your business fails.
You never saw me in your life. You saw a commercial on TV, you got on the phone with me, you spoke to me for 10 seconds, I gave you some names to call, and I gave you some things to look up, and you called me back 3 days later, and you wrote me a check for $50,000. Does that sound a little screwed up?
People want to believe that there is some opportunity that they can invest in that will guarantee that they will have financial success. There is no such thing. There just is no sure deal. None.
The best advice I can give to anybody who's looking to purchase a business opportunity or purchase any investment over the phone is fast no's and slow yeses. Period, the end. Fast no's and slow yeses.
If you're considering buying a business opportunity, get a written copy of the disclosure document. It includes information about the company, a list of previous purchasers, and information about lawsuits the company has faced from buyers. Get information in writing about earnings claims. This should include the number and percentage of recent buyers who earned at least as much as the company claims. Interview previous buyers of the business opportunity in person. The FTC requires business opportunity sellers to give potential buyers the names, addresses, and phone numbers of at least 10 previous purchasers. Resist the urge to buy a business over the phone. Promoters of fraudulent businesses are likely to tell you there are a limited number of opportunities, and this is the time to get in on a great deal. Finally, if you suspect that a business opportunity is fraudulent, report it to the Federal Trade Commission. Go to FTC.gov or call 1-877-FTC-HELP.
They're nice machines. Anybody out there want one? I'll give it to you free.